The next, I'm going to talk about the marginal propensity to consume, also known as MPC, and also the marginal propensity to save, also known as MPS. They are intertwined. So we start with your income. So after you get the income, the first thing you have to do is to pay tax. And after you pay your tax, you will have the disposable income. Once you get this disposable income, we call that DI, you can decide how much you want to spend and how much you want to save. So the amount that you spend will be your consumption, and the amount you save will be your saving. Here is the formal definition of marginal propensity to consume, also known as MPC. That's a change in consumption divided by the change in income. So for example, if you get a stimulus check in the amount of $3,000 and you spend $2,500 of that check on home improvement and you save the rest, then your marginal propensity to consume will be equal to the change in consumption divided by the change in income, which is equal to $2,500, the amount that you spend on home improvement, divided by $3,000, that's the amount of stimulus check you receive, that's the change in income. So you calculate that, you get 0.83. So 0.83 in this case will be equal to your marginal propensity to consume. Now here is a question about MPC. Other things being equal, does a wealthy person have a higher MPC or a poor person? Now you scratch your head and you're thinking, who will spend the entire stimulus check? The poor person or the rich person? And here's the answer. Typically, a poor person will have a higher marginal propensity to consume because you're more desperate. You really need to buy food. You really need to buy, say, new clothes for your growing children. So you're more likely to spend the entire stimulus check if you're poor. And here is an information I got from the government website. So in the COVID 2020, there was stimulus check saying that, hey, if your income is less than or equal to $75,000 as a single person, then you automatically get $1,200 stimulus money. That means, hey, if you your income is higher than $75,000, you don't get the $1,200 stimulus check. So you can see that in general, the government prefers to give money to the poor than to the rich. It's not because we don't like rich people, but rather because the poor person is more likely to spend the entire check, and that is going to cause more firms to make money, and that is going to give the economy a bigger kick. That's the reason why. Now you'll be asking, what about the wealthy people? Why don't they receive just as much stimulus money as the poor? Here is the reason why they don't receive as much stimulus money as the poor. Because the wealthy person, once they receive the stimulus check, a lot of that part of the check will go to the saving. So what's wrong with saving? Well, saving is a good way to stimulate the economy only if we're in a healthy economy and the firms are going to borrow the money from the bank, and the firms will be able to use the money to invest in more factories, equipment to produce more. But in a sluggish economy, say during the COVID recession, firms were not able to sell goods and services. And therefore, the wealthy saving would just stay in the bank, and the firm would not borrow the money from the bank. So your economy will still be sluggish, and giving money to the rich will not help stimulate the economy. That's the reason why the government gives money to the poor who have a higher MPC, and the poor people will spend the money to stimulate the economy. And the next, we're going to talk about the marginal propensity to save, also known as MPS. So by definition, marginal propensity to save is equal to the change of saving divided by the change in income. So continue with our example last time. You receive a stimulus check in the amount of $3,000 and you spend $2,500 for home improvement and you saved $500. Then your MPS is equal to the change in saving divided by the change in income. So that will be 500 divided by 3,000. That will give you 0.167. Notice that your MPC plus MPS is equal to 1. Why is that? Because, hey, if your income increases, then this increase in income either goes to consumption or it goes to saving. Therefore, the percentage of consumption plus the percentage of saving has to be equal to 100%. So MPC plus MPS is equal to 1. Let's try a practice question. Suppose John received a raise in the amount of $500 and he spent $410 on a new printer. What is John's marginal propensity to save? So the question asks you about MPS. That's tricky. So why don't you pause the video now and then work on it? Then we can compare our answers. So here is our solution. We'll first calculate John's saving. So the saving will be 500 minus 410. So that means John saved $90. And therefore, marginal propensity to save will be 90 divided by 500, which gives you 18%.